I will invite Julieta's collaborator, Andre Maya Chagas, who's going to talk about a mentorship program that he developed with Julieta and also Alex Kuchera, to be able to help grow best practices in open hardware. Andre, we're going to run into the break because we are behind because we started slightly late. And so please keep it in mind. I will come and bug you very promptly to try to keep us running a little bit on time. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Thanks, Nadia, for the introduction. It's great to be here. Thank you very much for all the organizers for putting the summit together. As Nadia May mentioned, I am going to talk about Open Hardware Makers, which is a mentorship program. All the slides are available on this link that you can see on the bottom, if you want to take a look at the links and things that are in this presentation. So, hello. As she also mentioned, I'm building this program with Julieta and Alex. We're two amazing human beings, and we have been working on this for a while now, and we hope that you all like what we have to share. So what are we going to talk about today? Like, why are we building this? What is it exactly how we're building it? We're going to ask for whoever wants to join to please join us, and then we're going to say a little bit of thanks in the end. Again, the presentation is on this link. And why? Why are we building a mentorship program around open hardware? I'm pretty sure everybody here already heard one, two, or all of these phrases here when talking about open hardware. We heard in the first talk from Megan that documentation,
Andre, making things. Your screen sharing is not on. You have to turn it on.
Genius. Sorry. Yeah. So, okay. So.
Yeah.
Yay. Okay. So just so you see Juliet and Alex here, this is the link. Maybe somebody can share this on the chat, please, for the presentation. So people might have already seen like these phrases, right? Like, I was trying to replicate something, but it was missing files. This is something that Megan mentioned. And Julieta also mentioned that like a lot of the things in open hardware projects is just not the technical stuff. So people need to understand a little bit better. And a lot of these issues make projects that are open source not be completely reusable and reshareable and so on, right? And we believe that this is not because people have bad intentions, but all honestly because they just, let's say, not know better or afraid or don't understand a certain aspect of sharing things early and often, right? And so this is why we're building this. We want people to have a place where they can go and learn the best practices for open hardware. Right, and we're going to see in a bit what we mean by best practices, and so as mentioned before, this is a program that we're building. But being open sourcers ourselves, we're not starting from zero. We're actually forking a program called Mozilla Open Leaders. This is now a retired program that was developed by Abby Cabs from Mozilla Foundation, and it was managed by her and Chad Sensing. So we basically forked this program and we heavily modified to what we needed, right? So the main idea is the same as Open Leaders, where we have a 15-week long program where you apply with a project and you get a mentor paired with your project. And on a weekly basis, you are working on this. So 1 week you have a call with your mentor, 1 week you have a call with the rest of the cohort that is running together with you. Through the middle of the program, more or less, we have a sprint where people can work on their they're going to be working on the projects regularly, but then they're going to do like more intensive work after an expert assessment, where experts are going to come in and tell different things that could be improved, that could be, you know, improved about their projects. The other members of the cohort from different projects are also going to be able to do peer review on each other's projects. And by the end of the 15 weeks, we're going to have an open call where everybody's going to be able to come and see what people have built. And hopefully by then, all the projects will be in a stage where everybody's super comfortable to share what they did, to onboard other people, and have proper documentation that people could already start collaborating right away. How is this different? And what do we mean by best practices, right? Of course, we're not just the three of us thinking about this, what we did was we took the program. We did a pilot in 2019 and 2020 together with Jose Yuha, but now the three of us are working on a completely built from the ground up model program where we did an online community call, an open call where people from all over the world came and gave suggestions on what we should improve, what we should change, which directions we should take the program in. And then with support from the Mozilla Foundation, we actually paid a group of experts to make comments and suggestions and help us structure the curriculum of the program. And so again, here, always thinking about how can we make this as global as possible, we had a panel of experts that was composed of 12 people, being 50-50 in terms of men and women. And we had basically two people from North America, one people from Central America, two people from South America. Then we had three people from Africa, three people from Asia, some people from Europe. So we tried to really distribute where people were coming from and what kind of expertise they had to contribute to the structure of the program. We also want, once we're done with the curriculum and ready to launch the first cohort, we want to translate this into different languages because, of course, not everybody speaks English and not all the awesome hardware projects that are available out there are documented in English. So we want to make this available in as many languages as possible. And we're also trying to focus on aspects that are a little bit different, as I mentioned, that only tech aspects. Because in a way, and I don't mean any offense to engineers, people have been engineering things since the beginning of time, right? Like in open source projects, normally the hard part is the human aspect of it, right? Like how do you document things? How do you onboard people? How do you make sure that the community is respected and feel respected and respects each other and so on? Also, we want to bring this and make this as a global thing because makers and open hardware developers are from all over the world, right? Like we look like this, we're all different, we're super diverse, but normally the represented or the mostly represented projects are from a small subset of this super diverse group. And so I think, or we want to believe that our strength is going to be onboard projects from all over the world and build a community of people who are really well versed in all of these aspects of open hardware and open projects that will be able then to contribute in the local communities, but also globally and increase representation in open source hardware. With this, I would like to call for your support and would like to call you to join our program. We are calling for mentors and experts at this time, also for partners and sponsors. We want to launch the first cohort around September, and this is why we're not calling for projects yet, because we don't want to raise expectations and that people have to wait a long time. And we also build an open collective. So if you'd like to buy us coffee, please go to our open collective page. This will help support us in paying for domain names and web resources and also for our time, because this is all built while we are taking care of our kids and families and work and our PhDs and all of this. And so having a little bit of extra money to pay for this time would be awesome. But also there in the Open Collective, you can see different tiers of how you can support, for instance, paying for a cohort or paying for a project so that the project participates in the program, or paying for mentors' time or an expert's time and things like this. I would like to say thank you very much for your attention. I would like to say thanks for the institutions that are already supporting our work. Basically, Oberlam, who's supporting Alex, where he's mainly working, Sussex Neuroscience, where I am working, Trend in Africa, this NGO that I collaborate with, who has served as our fiscal sponsor so far, Open Neuroscience, which is a project collecting open source projects for neurosciences, the GOSH community that Huli already mentioned, that is also hosting our forum, or is going to be hosting our forum when we launch the project. Here on the right side, you can see some links. We're on Twitter at OpenHWMakers. Also, super easy, our website is openhardware.space. And you can also send us an email at OHWMakers@gmail.com. Thank you very much.